Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Saturday of the 28th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. If you, O Lord, should mark iniquities, Lord, who could stand? But with you is found forgiveness, O God of Israel.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant us, O merciful God, protection in our weakness, that we who keep the memorial of the Holy Mother of God may, with the help of her intercession, rise up from our iniquities. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, it was not through the law that the promise was made to Abraham and his descendants that he would inherit the world, but through the righteousness that comes from faith. For this reason, it depends on faith, so that it may be a gift and a promise may be guaranteed to all his descendants, not to those who only adhere to the law, but to those who follow the faith of Abraham, who is the father of all of us, as it is written, I have made your father of many nations. He is our father in the sight of God, in whom he believed, who gives life to the dead, and calls into being what does not exist. He believed, hoping against hope, that he would become the father of many nations, according to what was said, thus shall your descendants be. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
You descendants of Abraham, his servants, sons of Jacob, his chosen ones, he, the Lord, is our God throughout the earth, his judgments prevail.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
He remembers forever his covenant, which he made binding for 1,000 generations, which he entered into with Abraham, and by his oath to Isaac.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
For he remembered his holy word to his servant Abraham, and he led forth his people with joy, with shouts of joy, his chosen ones.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Alleluia, alleluia. The Spirit of truth will testify to me, says the Lord, and you also will testify. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, I tell you, everyone who acknowledges me before others, the Son of Man will acknowledge before the angels of God. But whoever denies me before others will be denied before the angels of God. Everyone who speaks a word against the Son of Man will be forgiven. But the one who blasphemes against the Holy Spirit will not be forgiven. When they take you before synagogues and before rulers and authorities, do not worry about how or what your defense will be or about what you are to say. For the Holy Spirit will teach you at that moment what you should say. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we have a gospel reading that is very not complex also, but it needs a little bit of explaining or understanding. No, so first of all, Here the Lord says, if anyone who acknowledges me before the Son of, before others, the Son of Man will acknowledge before the angels of God. No? And whoever denies me before others will be denied before the angels of God. No? So when you take a look at this, it also reminds us, I think, what we do here and now will either, store up treasures for us in heaven. No? Remember when the Lord talks about he will acknowledge us before the angels of God. So we're talking about heaven. No? So maybe that's the first point that we will look at. No? And then the second point is that thing that people always ask, what does it mean to blaspheme? No? Blaspheme against the Holy Spirit, because according to the Lord, it is a sin that cannot be forgiven. No? And then the third point is the last part of the gospel talks about courage, no? In terms of our witnessing to our faith, and the courage that comes from the Holy Spirit. No? So these three points to reflect on. First, about our treasures in heaven. No? I think for me, this is a very nice reminder, no? that what we do here and now is what will somehow determine, no? our future. No? So if we store up treasures in heaven here, no? in the way we live our life, no? It's a lifestyle. Then it becomes for us a path, a preparation for heaven. No? In a sense, heaven does not happen in an instant, no? But it is really a way of life. No? Like very often, I used to tell people during recollections or retreats, especially during Lent and during Holy Week, I always remind people that, the Lord did not wake up one morning and said, okay, it's time to die on the cross. No? But it was a way of life. No? And we need to remember that even the Lord, no, slowly understood, no, his mission, and then it slowly revealed to him that the mission is the cross, no, while he had an inkling, no, the clarity of that mission came in the day-to-day, no, in the way he lived this life. And I think this is basically also what the first part is telling us, no, that our transition to eternal life really begins now, no, in the way we live our lives, no, if we acknowledge Christ, if we witness with our lives, with our day-to-day life, we witness to our faith in Christ. No, maybe that first point to reflect on, no, that heaven is here and now. No, in the way we live our life. No, and then the second is, anyone who blasphemes, no, before the Holy Spirit, no, or against the Holy Spirit. The idea here is, if you notice, it's very interesting. The Lord said that everyone who speaks a word against the Son of Man will be forgiven, but anyone who blasphemes against the Holy Spirit will not be forgiven. Here again, you need to realize that that here, why are we not forgiven? Because to blaspheme against the Holy Spirit is to refuse God's grace and God's power. No, so therefore, remember what we always say, that one of the amazing things with our God is that before us, in quotation marks, He is helpless, no? Until we say yes to Him, until we say yes to His grace, no? So therefore, that blasphemes against the Holy Spirit is to deny God, to deny the Holy Spirit. It is not to allow God to enter our lives. It is not to allow God to be part of our lives. So that is the meaning of that, no? To refuse God's grace and God's power, no? That's why, in a sense, His mercy will have no effect on us, no? Because we deny that. We refuse to acknowledge that, no? And perhaps that's something that we need to understand, no? Very, very, spiritually, but more clearly also, no? Even in our cognitive understanding of that, no? So that second point, no? And then the last point is, courage, no? Here you see Christ saying, "Do not worry about what you are to say. If they bring you to synagogues, no, and if they bring you before the rulers of this world, do not worry, because the Holy Spirit, no, will guide you. The Holy Spirit will teach you at that moment, no, what you should say." And that gives us the courage, no, because we know that at the time when we need and what we need, the Spirit will be there for us, no? The Spirit of Christ, the Spirit of the Father, the Spirit of the Trinity, no? For me, that is such a very strong reassurance for ourselves, no? Not that we become careless, no? And anyway, we say bahala na si Batman, no? Or God will take care of it. No. It is the courage to stay our course, to live our lives according to what we believe in, to our commitments, to what we have dedicated our lives to. And when the challenges come, it is to stand firm. No? It is to stand really on our principles and our commitment, knowing that the Spirit will be sent to us to guide us, no? And to tell us what to do. So for me, that is something very, very important for us to believe in, no? Because it will determine the way we live out our mission, the way we witness to Christ in the day-to-day, and it will determine also our courage. Siguro pag nilaya natin itong tatlong punto ito, na una sa lahat nga makikita natin na ang langit ay nagsisimula ngayon. Ano? Ang ating pananahan o paninirahan sa langit ay nagsisimula ngayon. Kung papaano natin isasabuhay, no, ang ating pananampalataya, ang mga bertud ng ating buhay, yun ang kumbaga nag-iimpok, ano, ng ating kayamanan sa kaharian ng Diyos sa langit, no. Kaya hindi ito biglaan, ano, isang araw isipin na rin, oh, sige, game na, no. Pero kung hindi, ito yung unti-unti natin pag ano, no, pagpapalalim, pagpapalago, ano, ng biyaya ng ating pagiging ano, mga citizens of heaven, ano. At yung pangalawang punto, no, yung sinasabi, paano kung tayo ay parang sumumpa, ano, laban sa Espiritu Santo, no? Ang kahulugan niyan ay hindi natin tinatanggap ang Diyos sa ating buhay. Hindi natin siya hinahayaang pumasok sa buhay natin. Tandaan niyo yung lagi nating sinasabi na ganun ka mahal tayo ng Diyos na bagaman napaka makapangyarihan niya, sa harap natin, ano siya, helpless. Unless ano, umuo tayo sa kanya. At yun yung ating pagsumpa laban sa Espiritu Santo, no, na hindi natin tinatanggap ang Diyos. Bakit hindi mapapatawad ang kasalanan? Kasi hindi natin tinatanggap ang pagpapatawad at ang habag ng Diyos, ano, ang awa ng Diyos, ang pagkalinga ng Diyos sa atin. At yung pangatlong huling punto ay yung katatagan ng loob, ano? Sabi nga ng Panginoon, 'di ba, sa Ebanghelyo, huwag kayong matakot pagka kayo ay dinala sa mga sinagoga at sa harap ng mga makapangyarihan, ang Espiritu Santo ang magagabay sa inyo. At yun ang isang napakalalim na ano, no, pagbibigay ng katatagan ng loob sa atin ng Diyos. Na pagka tinalaga natin ang ating sarili sa Kanya, lagi niya tayong gagabayan. Lagi niyang ipapadala ang Espiritu Santo. God is our security. Let us express our trust in Him and pray for all the people with whom we make the journey of life.
That the Church may continue to proclaim God's word in the face of contradiction and opposition, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may learn to trust in divine providence no matter how heavily our troubles weigh upon us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the unemployed may find work and earn their living with dignity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for all the intentions commended to our prayers. And let us pray most especially as we offer this votive mass to our Blessed Mother. Let us pray for peace in the Middle East, in Israel, in Gaza. Let's also pray for peace in Ukraine. For all of this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
As we honor the memory of the mother of your Son, we pray, O Lord, that the oblation of this sacrifice may, by your grace, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ
our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name in veneration of the Blessed Ever-Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived her only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. We pray most specially, Lord, for the victims of violence and all those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. Together, let us offer our prayer of consecration to Our Lady of Fatima.
As a pilgrim of the light that comes to us from your hands, I give thanks to God the Father, who in every time and place is at work in human history. As a pilgrim of the peace that in this place you proclaim, I give praise to Christ our peace, and I implore for the world concord among all peoples. As a pilgrim of the hope that the Spirit awakens, I come as a prophet and messenger to wash the feet of all at the same table that unites us. Hail, Mother of Mercy, Lady robed in white, in this place where 100 years ago you made known to all the purposes of God's mercy. In the depths of your being, in your immaculate heart, you keep the joys of men and women as they journey to the heavenly homeland. In the depths of your being, in your immaculate heart, you keep the sorrows of the human family as they mourn and weep in the valley of tears. In the depths of your being, in your immaculate heart, adorn us with the radiance of the jewels of your crown and make us pilgrims even as you were a pilgrim. In your immaculate heart, by the refuge of sinners and the way that leads to God, in union with my brothers and sisters, in faith, in hope, and in love, I entrust myself to you. In union with my brothers and sisters, through you, I consecrate myself to God, O Virgin of the Rosary of Fatima. And at last, enveloped in the light that comes from your hands, I will give glory to the Lord forever and ever. Amen.
And let us pray. Having been made partakers of eternal redemption, we pray, O Lord, that we who commemorate the mother of your Son may glory in the fullness of your grace and experience its continued increase for our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat. And again, please join us for Proyecto Pilipino. It's going to show in some of the cable channels, Sky Cable channels. And also this weekend for Journeys of Hope, we have a very interesting guest. No? He is, his name is JJ Agkawili. No? Young man, no? his parents are both doctors. He graduated from the Ateneo, BS Information Design. No? And he just finished his masteral studies in the Imperial College in London. And he entered an art contest with 1,350 plus entries. No, he is now in together with the no, no, he he became part of the 30 finalists, and then he won. He won the contest. Of course, it was also through online voting, but very interesting journey. So he's our guest for Journeys of Hope this weekend. So please join us for Journeys of Hope. Maraming pong salamat, and have a good day ahead. Have a good weekend ahead. Thank you.
Noong 2021, nakamit ko po ang isang bagay na matagal ko nang pinapangarap. Kahit na noong nagsisimula pa lamang ako sa showbiz, gusto ko na po talaga na makapagtapos ng pag-aaral. Pero dahil po sa kahirapan, marami pong mga Pilipino ang nahihirapang makapag-aral. At hindi po sila dapat mapag-iwanan. Paano po ba natin sila matutulungan?
Caritas Philippines Alay para sa Karunungan aims to help the marginalized children and youth to have access to quality education. Isinasakatuparan po natin ito sa pamamagitan ng dalawang programa. Una, Educational Assistance Program para sa mga academically challenged students. Since 2021, mayroon na po tayong 537 scholars.
Bawat isang scholar ay makakatanggap po ng monthly allowance. At hindi lamang yan, sa bawat 15 scholar, may nakalaang isang mahusay at matiyagang tutor.
Pangalawa, Alay Kapwa Community Schooling para sa mga out-of-school youth and young adults o OSYA. Opportunity to finish basic education, skills training, values formation, and better employment prospects. Ito ang hangad ng community schooling para sa mga OSYA.
In the coming years, palalawakin pa po ng Alay Kapwa ang bilang ng learner sa ating community schooling. Edukasyon para sa lahat, ito at ang ating Alay Kapwa.